This is Skizzy.
Skizzy.
Number one for showbiz and entertainment.
Commercial break. We're still chilling here, jamming, and of course it's Throwback Thursday. I'm very excited. You guys have been commenting in. People in Soroti, people in Mutiana, Mutiana, Masaka, Mbarara. Thank you all for watching the show. And checking out the music you guys are watching, we see Bonafide Girl, we see Beautiful Girls by Sean Kingston. Speaking about beautiful girls, I have a young lady who's here with me. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Happy on the show.
Thank you so much for hosting me.
Yeah, and of course, I don't want to introduce you, so I'm going to give you introducing yourself officially to my beautiful people watching you right now.
Okay, my name is Baby Gloria. Gloria Melinda Sanranja. The most of you call me Baby Gloria. I'm so happy to be in Skizzy today with Kashmir, and I hope that you have a good time. Keep on watching Urban TV.
Let me appreciate you looking smart today.
Thank you so much.
Stylist.
No, it's actually my mom and myself
really?
Sometimes. Yeah.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, the last time I heard about Baby Gloria, okay, I've been hearing about the name, but the last time I enjoyed music was like literally 10 years ago.
Wow, you need to keep on board,
when
man.
When you first released your first song, how old were you by then?
I was 2 years and 8 months, the time I recorded it, and then I did the video and I was 3 years.
3 years.
Yes.
Your mom told you, or you're already knowing what you're doing.
No, I loved it. Okay, this is the thing. She used to write songs on the dining.
Yeah.
So I'd also write ziggy zaggers on different papers and tell her, "Mommy, I'm also composing my own song."
Yeah.
So I started by, Mommy, jaga kutwale. And then she'd tell me, "Ontwale wa." Then I told her, "Shoprite or the ice cream." So for her, she took it to another level. I loved singing. I loved composing my own melodies. She took it to another level. She took me to studio. We did a video. And that's how I became Baby Gloria.
My beautiful sister loves you so much, Nancy. She's watching
you. Aww, thank you, Nancy.
And she says that you are our number one role model.
Aww, that's so sweet.
And perhaps next time, if you're coming through for the show, I'll make sure she also comes through.
Wow.
And you can take some pictures with her.
Wow, thank you, Nancy.
A couple of people are sending in questions, and of course, I'll be asking you some of them.
Yes.
But let's talk about you as a person.
Yes.
Starting with your school life. I mean, how far is school?
Right now, I'm in year 13. It's the last class of high school.
Yeah.
Yay!
Yes, cool.
Yeah.
Meaning you're now officially a big girl.
Yes, officially.
From where you're crossing to now?
I'm going to university.
Wow.
Yeah.
I mean, sounds interesting. Like, I thought year 3, maybe going to be year 14, 15 or something.
No. After this, I'm going to university.
How old are you right now?
Right now, I'm going to turn 18 in October 28th.
You're turning 18?
Yes.
Let me read a few questions from people who are... let me start on Twitter here. I screenshot someone. It says... Does Baby Gloria have a boyfriend, and who's that lucky dude? Please specify for us. This is Sadiq.
Wow.
People like to know if you have a boyfriend. tell them.
No, I don't.
You're not into dating?
No, I'm not into dating. No.
Wow. So where did that story of you being pregnant come from? Because I don't think people will really come up with such a story when they know you're not connected
to
anybody.
Right.
Tell me about the story.
The story about me being pregnant, I really don't know where it came from. It came twice. At first I was very young in P7. I wonder why someone put someone on a P7 child.
Yeah.
But anyways, it came. I think because I was lost for some time, wondering I was concentrating on my P7, wanting to get some good grades. Could be someone out there is cooking some story. But anyways, so we gave it a chill because it was self-explanatory. I was really young and someone could just tell it's not true.
Like, whoa,
yeah,
really true.
Exactly. So then when I was older, it came back. I don't know how. So it was, this time it was all over. It was bombarding everything.
Yeah.
It went in newspapers. Every presenter was talking about it. It was everywhere, every social media platform.
How's your life at school?
My life at school?
Your normal life at school. How did, do you have a... so many of your fellows looking up to you. Everyone wants to be around you. You're famous.
I'm actually a very normal person, by the way. I like it when people get to know me for who I am. I don't want them to be friends, you know, because they know I'm famous and all that. I want to be normal. I want to be like, I want them to know me for who I am. So it's really so hard until they get to know that. But before that, some people have their own perspectives. Some people are like, I think he ate a guy. I'm just kidding. But after that, they get to find out that I'm actually a fun person, crazy.
Somehow you used the opportunity of people talking about you being pregnant, and you came up with a song called...
That's right. Mbundi Lubuto.
The chorus of the song very well. I was watching the song yesterday at night on YouTube. I watched it like 5 times.
Wow.
Okay, just give them a little bit of a couple of the song because they're going to watch it at the end of this interview.
Cool, cool. Here's my sweetest song, Munibemuinbira, and you gave me one to Muninda. My sweetest song, Munibemuinbira, and Wumuzeme Meyange.
Beautiful.
That's, yeah.
Are you really going to pursue music for the rest of your life, or somewhere, somehow, you have other plans?
The truth is, I'm going to continue singing, doing different things, maybe worship nights and all that. But then I want to pursue something else professionally, something that's going to give me good money. I've always said this, I want to be a rich woman. So, yeah, I'm going to pursue something else. I just need to find out what it really is.
It's talking about something else because you're almost literally 19, yeah?
Yeah.
By now, I believe you have something you feel like you're interested in doing so much.
Yes, right? The thing is, I have something with my tongue because I have tongue speak and all that. So I have to use my tongue somehow, either in international relations or mediating for people in the UN or marketing. I don't know. I have to do something with, you know, for what God gave me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Before we finalize, I'd like to know, how many songs have you produced so far?
Are
you working on an album, just solos or something of the sort?
I've produced so many songs. Just imagine 2 years and 8 months in the age I am now. Right. So I have so many songs.
I know.
I can't even count. I have so many songs.
All right. You told me you're about to get back to school. And
yes.
When are you going back to school?
I'm going back to school next week on Tuesday.
Oh, okay. You remind me of those days.
I know.
Are you excited to go back to school or are you feeling sad?
For my school, yeah, I'm excited. It's really fun.
Sure then.
Yes.
All right. Finally, what are your plans for 2019?
2019, I'm really, really expecting a lot of things, big things. I'm going to be premiering new videos.
Yeah.
I'm going to be featuring in my own movie. I'm going to be acting my mom's
sure.
My mom's life. Yeah. So you need to call me and premiere it. Okay, thank you. God willingly, I want to do a big concert, like a concert called The Rebrand, because I'll be 18. So I want to do it. God willingly.
Sounds like an interesting idea.
Yeah. Amen.
All right. Are you going to stick to gospel music or you have plans of also trying to?
No, I'm going to stick to gospel music. I believe I was born to sing for God, to minister to people's lives, to inspire.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody want to send greetings to?
Greetings to my parents, to all you my fans, Manange. Thank you so much for loving me, for keeping our music in your ears, Manange. You really, really, really add a lot to us. I love you.
All right, give me a high five. Thank you for coming through. All right,
you're welcome.
Thank
you.
One of our Hale's projects, Muniru Buto. Check out the video. It's an interesting video. You're going to love it. And when I come back, we still have more coming up on the show. I'm going to be reading your comments. Javino, so you're watching in from Seguku. Thank you so much. Blessings.
Thank you.